For this lesson, you need to open the sample file Empire Car Sales Stock List from your Sample Files folder. Excel shares the same powerful spell checker that's included with Word and other Office applications. Most European companies have a corporate standard for their spelling, often American English or British English. Excel also includes standard support for 18 different dialects of English, as well as other languages. While most words are included in Excel's dictionary, you'll often be warned that a correct spelling is misspelt. When this is the case, you can add the word to the dictionary, so that Excel doesn't keep bothering you about it in the future. Let's now look at the sample worksheet for this lesson. We'll have to hope that Empire's cars are better than their spelling, because the selling points column contains many frequently incorrectly spelled words. You might find it fun to try to identify their spelling errors before we set the spell checker loose on the job. First of all, I'm going to check the spelling for words in the range F5 to G6. So I'll select cells F5 to G6 and then click Review on the ribbon and in the Proofing group, the Spelling button. If all of the words are spelled correctly in the range, the spell checker doesn't display. But in this case, there are errors, so the spell check dialog is displayed. In this case, notice that the dictionary language is set to English United States. This means that the British spelling of the word colour does not appear in the American English dictionary, because in America it's spelt C-O-L-O-R. If your dictionary was set to English United Kingdom, you wouldn't see this error, because C-O-L-O-U-R is the correct UK English spelling. Let's look at the different languages available in Excel. And you can see that the English version of Excel includes support for English, French and Spanish dialects. Microsoft also offer language packs for 35 other languages, ranging from Chinese to Ukrainian. Let's just go back and change the language to English United Kingdom. Notice that colour is no longer being picked up as a spelling error. But I'll now change back to English United States. I'll close the dialogue and reopen it. And you can see that once again, colour is being picked up as a spelling mistake. Well, I'm going to correct that now by clicking the Change button. And you can see that colour has now changed on the worksheet to the correct spelling. The next error is the word accelerate, and you can see that it's incorrectly spelt in the worksheet, so I'll click Change to correct the spelling. And Excel tells me that there are no more errors in the selected range. Sometimes you'll spell a word and you'll think perhaps you've made a spelling mistake, but you're not really sure, and you'd like to check that single word to make sure it's correct. Let's look at the word conscientious in cell G7. Perhaps you think that you may have made a mistake. So I'll double-click in cell G7 to enter edit mode, and then I'll click and drag across the word conscientious. I can now spell check the single word. So I'll click Review tab on the ribbon, and in the proofing group, spelling. And you can see that I was correct. Conscientious is spelt incorrectly, so I'll click the Change button to correct it. So we've now seen how you can check the spelling in a range of cells, and also how you can check the spelling of a single word. But most likely, you'll want to check spelling of all of the words in a worksheet. Now look at the active cell. At the moment, it's in cell F13. And the way the spell checker works is that if I invoked a spell check now, Excel would check all of the cells to the right of the active cell and beneath the active cell. So it wouldn't actually check any of the words in this worksheet. Let's try that and see it happen. I'm going to click the spelling button, and Excel asks me if I want to continue checking at the beginning of the sheet, because the only cells that have been checked are the cells to the right of and beneath cell F13. Let me close that dialog now and suggest that when you spell check an entire sheet, you should first click in cell A1. You'll then check all of the text in the worksheet, and you won't have to waste a mouse click continuing to check when that dialog's displayed. So I'll now click the spelling button again, and because there are spelling errors, the spelling dialog appears. The first error that's been found is the word achieves, and you can see that that's been incorrectly spelt as EI instead of IE. So I'll click the change button to correct the error. Next I have particularly rather than particularly, so I'll click change to change that word to the correct spelling. And now I have recognised instead of recognised, so I'll change that to the correct spelling. And this is an interesting one, because alphacid is a real word. It's a car model that was produced by Alfa Romeo between 1976 and 1989, but it isn't in the Excel dictionary. Perhaps Empire sells a lot of alphacids and doesn't want to be pulled up by the spell checker every time the word's used. To prevent this from happening, I'm going to add the word alphacid to the dictionary so that Excel will recognise the word in the future. So I'm going to click the Add to Dictionary button on the spell check dialog. Of course, before you do this, you should be absolutely sure that the word is spelt correctly. So I'll click Add to Dictionary now, and the word is now in the dictionary. And the final error is the word connoisseurs, which you can see is incorrectly spelt. So I'll click the Change button to correct the spelling. And Excel tells me the spell check's complete, so I'll click OK to dismiss the dialog. All that remains now is to save your work, and I'm going to save with the new name Empire Car Sales Stock List 1, and as usual I'll save to the folder above my sample files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed lesson 320, Check Spelling.